As I said before, there's a lot we're still working on. Just watch your step on the way out, and as a reminder, Aperture Science Innovators is not responsible for any injury you sustain. Up to and including death by exposure to cosmic ray spallation. Don't worry though, we haven't had an accident like that in 3 days. Sorry. Make that 3 minutes. Here at Aperture Science Innovators, we love to give back to the community. So, instead of just giving back, we made our own community, entirely made out of Aperture Science malleable concrete on top of the salt mines. And that's exactly why you shouldn't touch the walls or stomp your feet either. Last thing we need is to touch up a dent in the wall because someone was too hands-on. I told you it was easy to find. You found it faster than any test subjects on record. that's not good. Just head through the door on the right to the elevator. You all know where to go. So, at first, I wanted to put in a long flight of stairs that spiraled down through the old salt mines down here. Give the test subjects a great view of the place. But no! The zoning boards on my bean counter said that's why they invented elevators. So, when someone in a wheelchair threatened to sue, my former boys chickened out of me and built this elevator to go to our temporary offices. I'm still working on those stairs, and those guys are working on getting new jobs. Seriously though, the stairs aren't ready, so get on that stupid elevator. Here at Aperture, we're always trying to push the boundaries of science that little bit more. That's why we're taking on this new project. When the bean counters told me not to buy a salt mine to do all this science, the first thing they said was, "No, there's too much space. You can't suspend something over nothing and pray that a test could happen in thin air." Well, thanks to some use of the old calculator between the ears and a generous helping of the "You're Fired" stamp, I came up with a final solution to that. If you can't anchor something in thin air, why bother trying to make it in the air in the first place? I came up with this. Introducing the Aperture Science Innovators Suspended Testing Sphere. Each sphere is suspended in the air, anchored to the walls by concrete and steel lattice rebar. They seem like they float in the air, but in fact, they don't. Plus, we can keep building above them, onward and upward. This salt mine here can take at least 10 of these bad boys per shaft. 9 shafts, 90 tests. We can test whatever we want to and beat that other company into the ground. Black Mesa. Those guys can kiss my... Anyway, the bean counters cried like babies when they saw the cost of these things, but they wet their pants when they threw them out the door. I pay the bills, I make the decisions around here, and I hire and fire as I please. The first of these spheres won't be ready for a few more months, so you'll be participating in one of our smaller tests, the Aperture Science Innovators Short-Term Relaxation Vault. When you get to the offices, I'll tell you a bit more. This test should be real easy for you, though. Just get inside one of the Aperture Science Innovator's short-term relaxation vaults and lie in a bed. You'll feel yourself fall asleep quickly. Don't worry, though. Our science boys will get you out shortly. You'll only be out for a few minutes. An hour, at most, if something goes wrong. Don't worry. We've got everything under control. You'll be making science, and you won't have to do a thing. Who's the winner here?
You are.
Pre-recorded message, you'll be heading into an Aperture Science Innovator's short-term relaxation vault for a quick, deep sleep, and then you're done. That's why we brought you here at night. You're most likely a walking zombie. That'll give us the best results. But just remember, don't sleep too long. This isn't a bed and breakfast, and if you decide to stay tonight, I'm charging you rent for the next year. We'll have a bed ready for you. Just follow the testing area signs and go to bed. Don't mind the turrets. They're firing blanks. At least that's what Crazy Harry told me. Had six science boys disappear because of him. Those turrets won't kill you. The safety on their guns is on. Had some lab boys shut them down. Crazy Harry lied to me. If you're hearing this message, you're at the sleeping chamber. Carolyn, is the test ready?
Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson.
Then you're good to go. Step into the chamber and get into the bed. Our lab boys will take care of the rest.
Is this thing on? Hello? Hello? Can you hear me? Oh, right, you can't answer. I'm so sorry, astronaut, Olympian, or war hero. There was a slight problem with the test. Don't worry, though. We got you out okay. Nothing's different. Nothing's changed. Just head out of the chamber. I'll tell you a bit more out there. Don't Don't worry about the heights. Had a few of my scientists make what's called long fall aperture science innovators long fall boots.
That was easier to think of than I thought.
Pick that yellow device up. Don't worry, it's not hazardous. I've had the scientists leave you a new device to help you. Yeah, that's right. A new test. Congratulations! You get to test something else now. Double the experiments for you. There's an open door nearby. Should take you out of the building. You'll need that new test to move around. But don't worry though, we built the building like this. Don't worry about that. It's just a new drilling test we're doing down below.
Yeah,
to get the salt mines deeper, to get more testing spheres in.
Yeah,
that's it. Just ignore that. Don't mind all this too, we just had earthquakes. Lots of earthquakes.
Yeah,
you get lots of those here in Michigan. These earthquakes even shook up time a bit. Some stuff from the future got here.
Yeah,
that's how it's here. Don't worry, it's still 1952. Adlai Stevenson is still president. Alright, so, the earthquakes. Kinda did some redecorating in here. Destroy the door too. You'll have to find another way out. There's gotta be something you can use to launch yourself over the door. There has to be another way out. I know, things might look different than what you're used to, but while you were spending that little time sleeping, we had some aperture science nanomachines come in and build all this stuff. Yeah, that's it. They're quick little guys. Faster than any science guy I got. Now, I just want to make sure you know something before you go any further. We have these new inventions called emancipation grids in place to prevent objects from moving around to other tests. Now, some guy decided that it would be a good idea to make ones that prevent people from going through, and installed one where people needed to go through. If you turn the power off, you can easily turn it back on. That switch isn't like the rest of them. The others trip a circuit breaker. I think these switches were designed for two people. Maybe your new test can help. Remember, you can always turn the power on or off again. The new testing track is just through here.
Just to test your, reflexes, you know, after your short sleep. Bravo Volta, the... hold on. Fifth testing track, yes, fifth. You'll need a portal device to get through. Sorry, I meant a portable quantum tunneling device. Look, it's in your hands right now. The scientists did their job. You'll do fine. About this test is lead-lined, according to my 1950s notes here in my 1950s filing cabinet. Says it's harmful to humans. Not harmful to humans. You'll be okay. Perfectly fine. Nothing to worry about. Don't worry about the boxes. We got a ton backstocked ready for this kind of thing. Thrown at the wall, destroyed, rinse and repeat. Useless little things. Made them in an hour. That high toxicity lead didn't get in the air and, great job, astronauts, Olympian, or war hero. You really are a merit to science, or something like that. Just remember the Nuremberg Olympics. Now see, this test uses the new Aperture Science Innovators propulsion gel. It allows you to... no, wait, hold on. This record says they didn't make that until the 70s. Never you mind that. Just, solve science.
Oh, hold on a second, Mel. I don't think you're that stupid that you're going to
fall for this anymore. I'll be blunt now. I'm not Cave Johnson. This isn't the 1950s. Everyone you knew and loved is dead. And now you're stuck here in Aperture Science, down with the trash. Like me. After everyone left because of that boat. Which I'm sure you already knew, but whatever. However, I can get us out of here. If you're willing to let a voice in the sky who just told you he was lying the entire time he was talking to you control nearly every movement you make. Is that okay? I'll just take your silence as a yes. Oh, right, you can't answer me. Just do what I say and you'll be fine. Okay? About before. You can get why I said all that, right? I'd rather not have my one chance of escape have a panic attack and die on me after years of being suspended in a faulty relaxation vault. Which could be a real possibility, because as my records show, the old test could cause heart attacks after small exposure to the chemicals. And you were pumped full of them. So, let's all just take a breath and start over. My name's Virgil. I'm a core from up in the Enrichment Center. And before you even think of asking, yes, there is a building above you, and yes, I came from it. I'm not crazy. Don't be too alarmed, though. A lot's changed since you got put on ice. See that pipe there, that the repulsion gel's leaking on? That'll take you to the pumping station. Jump down and walk on it. Oh, and try not to fall off. That goo down there is corrosive, and it doesn't like human skin. To my records of this room, there should be a turret shooting range at the far side of the room. If you can get through there, you should be able to get to the fourth testing track.
That'll take you up to where I am. Normally when people do that sort of thing, they just fly through the hole in the wall. I guess not this time. Good! That gel should help you get past those turrets. Good! That gel should help you get past those turrets. A straight shot to the next testing track. Go to that door down at the very end. You know, the one with the giant wheel on it. Do it again. It'll open this time, I swear. Just give it some elbow grease. Oh, come on, you got this. One more shot. Well, great. You can fling yourself all over the place and get past some old turrets that are firing live rounds, but you can't get a door open? What kind of Olympian are you? Ugh. Alright, let's see what we can do. There's a longer route through a repulsion gel pumping station. Guess you're going to have to go that way. You can get through this pumping station and prepare yourself to get out of Brava Volta into the Lima Whiskey testing track. That should bring you closer to me and to your own escape from this facility. Alright, I know what you're thinking. What on earth is going on here? Well, Aperture's early tests weren't always that successful. You were unlucky. That was the worst test Cave Johnson ever greenlit. But it's nice for me to have an Olympian at my disposal. Yeah, I have that information from you at the 1936 Nuremberg Olympics. You should have gotten that silver medal.
The local zoo made an offer we couldn't refuse, so you may encounter several grizzly bears and or lions in this next test. The local zoo made an offer we couldn't refuse, so you may encounter several grizzly bears and or lions in this next test.
All right, look, I'm sorry for what I said back there. We're in this together. You're my ticket out of the junkyard down here. I'm your ticket to the outside world. I'll do my best to keep the insults at a minimum.
I kind of have a bit of bad news. Yeah, I know. You don't want to hear any more bad news after the security override. I couldn't do.
My records of this sphere are out of date, to say the least. There should be an exit after the third section of this test. However, I don't know if getting there will be that easy.
You got it in you, though. You're my Olympian.
Who might not have a beating heart anymore. Second, I'm getting some strange voice coming through. I'll patch it through.
Scanner, Lima Whiskey, 70% complete. No vital signs detected. Initiating flooding procedure.
That's coming up from New Aperture.
My scans are going nuts. Something's happening. The sphere's unstable. Get out of here. Run!
Thank you. explosion blew the whole toxic goo pump station apart. It's letting flood waters up. We gotta get out of here. It's not safe. Get through the control centers. There's a transition seal leading up to where I am. Hurry, before this whole place floods or comes down. Rocks are falling everywhere, and you're taking the elevator! What if the power went out? You'd be trapped! Get out of there. The room's filling with smoke. Good. At least you won't suffocate in this room. But whoa! No, don't do that! You won't bring the place down on your head? Believe that worked. Oh, right, get going before something else happens. Wow, if you'd been there a few seconds earlier, you'd have been incinerated. Thank the maker you were, though. I need the muscle. When the pump station blew, the floodgates opened up wide. Toxic goo rising fast, the sensors maxed out ages ago, warning lights, woo, going crazy all around. This just got a lot more serious. Control Center 95D. Only a bit further and you'll be at the hatch up to me. Hurry. I'll try to slow the goo down a bit. Oh, great. Another blocked corridor. The door won't open from this side. Maybe there's some other way around or something. So, Mel, why don't you take your time? Look around here. I'll try to slow the rising goo down a little bit harder, I guess. Just don't take all day. Great job, Mel. You're on the other side of that door now. Yes! Very good. doors are locked?
Back in the day, the wiring was a bit strange sometimes. Try turning some machinery on, see if that also unlocks the doors.
Wow, that actually worked. I mean, great! Well, that's just great. Can't we get through a room once without stuff blowing up or blocking our way? Ugh. Try to find some water again or something. Great. From there, there's just the walls. Don't get comfy, though. I pulled the plug on some emergency runoff dams, but the goo is still rising. Wow! This place is massive! Whoever built this place must be a great architect. Up high, at the back side of this room, is a control panel. It controls the hatch. Try to get there. records show that at least two people were needed to activate the voltage. You're one person. There's a bit of a problem there. I'm sure we can figure something out. Eating us alive. I'll seal up the hatch and we don't have to worry about that anymore. That's definitely a plus.